As soon as you get rid of one traffic problem, another one pops up.
During rush hour,
it is almost impossible for commuters and students to get from the suburbs to work or school. We do have a central station that connects the suburbs to the city center, but it's not very appealing, and I can understand why no one would want to spend time there. For quite a while now, people have been demanding a renovation of the train station area to make the waiting periods more pleasant for commuters. The construction plans include a modern lounge. The city can't afford anything more at the moment, but it is certainly a good investment.
Start on the far side. Have to get it lined up. Right, get it lined up and press F, I think it is. There we go. Costs us 351 because we didn't keep it for the full day. Right, jobs is excavation, trench, skip, yes. Okay, deliver construction material. I think this one is what we need. See how the flatbed could have taken all this stuff. Pretty sure it wouldn't have. Right. That crane. Last time we got the L1 crane, it was too short on the boom. Just over here somewhere. I think I saw one. Yeah, there it is. Is that it there? On the outside? doesn't look like it matches. Oh well. Let's just put it in the designated area for now. Pivot and drop it into place. Quiver foundations. Okay, let me just get out of the crane for a moment. Sort out the truck. Ah, that's okay. That's where that's going next. I see. We need to unpack as well. Right, let me just close up. Go, it's parked. You can use the reset function to do that. So now with the crane, we're going to place these, what do they call them? Quiver foundations. They look like pillar support foundations. Oh, excuse me. Last one. Oh, more stuff for us to move. Unpack. I love how everything is so compact in this. It's bizarre. Things that should be technically take up more space don't. Let me see, which one is it? Oh, it's these construction material frames. Do you know what would be cool actually, and they'll probably come in DLC or a feature later, is 3D printed houses. If that doesn't come to this game, there's something seriously wrong. I was looking at the roadmap earlier now. I didn't particularly notice it being mentioned. That doesn't mean it's not going to happen. Right, pillars. What's the funny icons on the ground there? Oh, so those correspond to... Right, okay. Yeah, these look like they correspond to the actual concrete that's on the ground here. See, yeah, so that'll... lying down flat, which means we have to bring them up. Ta-ta-ta-ta! Core strip foundation. Yeah, that's monotonous. Job, that, skip. There we go, foundation is done. Deliverance bread gravel. We are looking for gravel. So the gravel should be coming out of a white vertical hopper. This looks like it here. Or is that the cement? No, that one's the cement. It's the grey one over there with the corrugated walls on it. in the yellow line at the bottom right, the circle, is capacity. And we're full, right. Now, where are we putting this gravel? Ah, okay. Assuming this is what it wants us to do. Right, now, let's see, what does it say for the spreading part? Doesn't. Alright, skip. 125,000 due for slab foundations. Move to the marker on the construction and unpack the materials. Ah, this will be another crane job. Oh, that's what it meant by spread. Okay, don't know how we were going to do that, or what with. Right, where's the ones we have to unpack? Wow. That's cool. Poor slab foundation. Yeah, don't have the patience for that. Job, that, skip. Yes. So this must be what we earned out of what we could have gotten. So had we done the slab foundation, we would have gone 125,000. Oh my god. Wait a minute. So does that mean we only got 1,000 out of that? Unpacking again. Okay. This place elevator shafts. Okay, it's a crane job. Reset crane. think we're going to end up doing some concrete pouring. This is costing me so much if I don't. Right, looks like the last part of both of those is concrete. So we're going to need the pump and the mixer. Need to work our way towards 12 as it is, so might as well buy one of them. Right, now what we're going to do now is go get the is it the mixer we want to get first? Yeah, doesn't really matter actually. The dump truck, do we need any more? No, we don't. Return that. Concrete pump. Enter. Let's fill her up. Yeah, that looks like it will meet it. So, if I remember right, F. Pouring. There we go. G to get out. Okay, do we have... No, there is no rigors on this. Need to close the parking, close the brake, and it's in neutral. That's all that matters. Yeah, bring this way. Right, so this is where the 3D print and the buildings thing would come in handy, but we have to do it manually. Swing her out. Oh, the other way, the other way, the other way. No, is that not meant to... Yeah, keep going. Oh yeah. then you have to move it to the opposite to get it to go where you want it to go. That's it, go on, keep, no, up again, yeah. Right, let's check the camera view. Extend, ah yes, now I have it. Right, bring that back. Up a little bit. Up. Here we go. Nearly had it. No, does it have to go actually into it or just... No, I think that's all right. Hit the space bar. Watch it fill up. There we go. Don't overflow it though. Nice. Bring it down. Too quick. Yeah, just about there. It does take get a bit tight. Take a bit of time to get used to the, as I refer to it, spatial awareness of it, of operating this type of equipment. You have to think about which elbow, which arm you're moving. You're not going to get it right all the time, even when you do think you have it figured out. The usual thing of just when I figured it out, goes pear-shaped or... That's it, bring the arm back. Up. No, bring it up. Yeah, now bring it across. Up again. No. So the up and down arrows are the second arm, but W and S is the first. It's that one. So that's at its highest peak. And there's this second one. It's just trying to get a balance between the two. Hold on, but that looks like it's filling it all out for me now. So if I stay in the same spot for long enough, will it actually? Yes, it will. Oh, thank you, Eureka. Now, I'm not sure one mixer is going to have enough cement for all of this. We shall see. Bingo. Nice. Oh, got a nice chunk of change for doing that as well. Right, reset that puppy. Send the company vehicle pump
tour.
Store that. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Which is it actually for the most expensive crane? But look, I think I want to invest in one permanently. So there's the L1. We know that's the smallest range. That's the one we have at the moment. And I think this is the one we want. Oh no, it's actually that one. Okay, 256. What have we got now? We might need the money for materials, so we'll wait. Okay, so these are different sizes. Yeah, that's why there's some are showing as a different color. I like a lighter, yeah, that's why that one was highlighted. That makes sense. Hallelujah. Right. How much is the next part worth? 62,000 out of 100, and it's a lot. 280,000. Yeah, we're definitely doing this one. Yeah, it's highlighted. Ah, that sound at the end, actually. That seems to be when it's working properly. The xenomorph. Deploying. Fancy roof over there. Concrete that ceiling as well. Yeah, this top bit doesn't make a whole lot of sense, does it? Right, let's place the platform roof over here. Wish we could get a worker doing the pouring the concrete is the only equipment. Oh, hold on. Where is... Oh, I see it. Here in the corner. Nearly didn't see that. Almost there. Down. How big are these sheets? This does not want to go down correctly, does it? And we get to pour more concrete. So what else would we be doing on a construction yet? Reset the crane. There we go. Ooh, that's the biggest payday I think we've had so far. She ran out of money.
The new waiting area is so modern and inviting. A place where you don't mind staying, even for longer periods. It's also nice to see that the old building has been preserved, and with it, a piece of the city's history.